So in the last session, we have calculated the work done in changing the volume of a hydrostatic system. We obtained the expression dW is equal to minus PdV. That was a infinitesimal work done in changing the volume of the system by a small amount dV. Therefore, we can obtain the work done in a finite quasi-static process as just by integrating W equal to minus integral PdV. Since volume is a variable here, let me write from VI the initial volume to the final volume VF. So in order to show that it is from I to F, or initial volume to the final volume, let me rewrite this one as some WIF. So this equation gives you the work done in changing the volume of the system quasi-statically from VI to VF. Now you can see from the integral that if you interchange the upper limit and the lower limit, this negative sign can be reversed. So on the LHS now it becomes WFI. So that will be from VF to VI. The volume changes from VF to VI. Or you can conclude that WIF is nothing but equal to minus of WFI. Now let us see what is the physical meaning of the area that is enclosed by a PV diagram, or what is the area under a PV diagram. So for that I'm considering a simple PV diagram in which the pressure is remaining constant. You can take any other general PV diagram as well, but for simplicity I'm taking an isobaric process. So in the isobaric process you have got here, you say that the pressure is kept at some constant value P here, and let the volume be changed from some initial value of volume, say 0, to some final value of volume, say V. Now you know the area under this curve, I'm just shading it for the time being. So this shaded area I'm interested in. Being a rectangle, you know the area under the curve. So I'm just writing area under the curve, or area under PV diagram, area under the PV diagram for the system. I can say area equal to, of course being a rectangle, you know it is a length into breadth. So on one side it is simply P, 0 and P, so it is P times on the other side it is simply V, the volume, 0 to V. Now let us see dimensionally what is this representing. So you know by definition pressure is nothing but force per unit area. So let me write this one simply as pressure per unit area, times what is volume. Can you write this volume as usual as something like area into some thickness or something like that, to get a three-dimensional idea. This thickness here in the case of a cylinder with a movable piston will become the displacement of the piston itself. So let me cancel out the area. Area here in our cylinder piston case becomes area cross-section of the piston. So you know what you are finally left with? You are left with simply force times the displacement. And you know what is force into displacement in mechanics? You know that is nothing but representing the work done. Work done, W. So this is something very very important, that area under the PV diagram, it's already a result that is well known to you. So area under PV curve, area under PV curve for a thermodynamic process represents the work done, work done, work done. So that is our final conclusion. Now, you know, in mechanics, we have just learned about conservative and non-conservative forces, and you know that work done during a process can either be conservative or non-conservative, or we can say the force involved is conservative or non-conservative based on the path dependent nature of the work done. So in mechanics you can see for example in the case of work done against or work done in the case of conservative forces like gravitation etc. are path independent. So there are path independent works defined in the case of conservative force, path independent if forces are conservative. That is the concept that you have learned in your basic mechanics courses. Best example is work done against gravitational force, is it not? Work done against gravitational force, against electrostatic force, etc. So you know these are some examples of what you call as conservative forces. So all these work done are basically path independent works. But at the same time you have learned that certain work, if it is done against non-conservative forces like friction, viscosity, etc., are what becoming path dependent. So in the same manner you will see that in the case of thermodynamic work also, some work is basically, or in general, thermodynamic work is path dependent. In general, thermodynamic work is path dependent. This is something that you have to keep in mind. In general, I'm just telling in general, means there are some exemptions that is permitted. That is why I specify in general. Or we can say that the work done in changing the volume of a system, or we can say the hydrostatic work is in general path dependent. So we will prove this statement by taking some specific examples so that we will do. And before going to the proof of that statement, let me first discuss the area under the PV diagram with some more inputs. So here in the diagram here I have taken three different cases. So just you look at figure number one or figure A, in which the process is changing the volume from some initial value, say Vi. So you have got some initial value for the volume here. So let me say that here you have got some initial value of volume Vi, and the final value of the volume has become Vf. So there is a change in volume that is accompanying the process. So you can see the arrow in the diagram that represents from I to F. So Vi increases to some Vf here. So it's clearly a process of expansion. It's a process of expansion represented by the curve here, PV diagram here. Now, you know, that there is an area shaded that is below the graph. And of course, that area represents the work done. So in figure A, the area represents the work done. Work done in expanding the system, from, we can say, Vi to Vf. The work done in expanding the system from Vi to Vf. So you can see, as per our understanding, that is nothing but you have to make an integral minus integral from Vi, the lower limit initial point, to the final point Vf. Simply P, the pressure involved, into dV, P dV. Remember one thing, unlike the previous case here, actually the pressure is not remaining constant in the process. That is something to be noted here. Both pressure as well as the volume is changing here. So that is one reason why I am not permitted to take the pressure here out of the integral straight away. How we will solve this problem, we will see in the coming sessions. Anyway, remember that, we are not permitted to take the pressure outside the integral, because during the process shown in diagram A here, the pressure is also varying. Okay, so I will keep this integral as such. So this is the first case. So that is shown by the shaded area below the curve. Now, so that is the first figure A. Now let us go to the figure B in the diagram. So you know, what is the figure B in the diagram representing? You can see the figure B in the diagram, the arrow shows that the process is proceeding from a final volume Vf to an initial volume Vi. So you know that Vi is now less than Vf. So the process is representing a compression. System is getting compressed here. So here you can see the area under the curve is just denoting the work done in compressing the system. So in figure B, work done in compressing the system is shown as compressing the system from, I can say, Vf, which is a greater volume, to an smaller volume Vi. And you know what would be that thing, you can just see that is shown by the area under the curve. So you will have to write the integral also in the reverse way. Remember, that is from Vf, okay, to Vi, Vf to Vi, pdv. Remember, the two values are not equal. The value of integral number 1 and the value of integral number 2 are not equal, as you can see from the area here. So this is the area under the curve. The area under the both the curves A and B are not equal. Okay. Now, you know, as per our sign convention, what about the equation number 1? What about the work done in equation number 1? That is in expanding the system. You know, the work done in expanding the system as per our convention adopted is, it is work done is by the system in expansion. So that work done is negative. And the second one is representing the work done in compressing the system. And so in compressing the system, work is done on the system. Hence, the work done should be taken as positive. So that is something to be taken care of. So this work done is negative. So the first case, the work done is negative. Here the work done is negative work. Here the work done is what? Positive work. So in that sense, you have to take one area as negative area and the other area simply as positive area. Now you can go to the third diagram. Then it makes some sense here. In the third diagram, you can see from initially, see, it has gone to this one and it has just gone back this way. Okay, so it represents the PV diagram for what is known as a cyclic process. So it has come back to the initial stage, Vi to Vf, then finally from Vf back to Vi. So this is what is known as a cyclic process. So how do we get the work done during a cyclic process? You can see in the cyclic process, the work done that is equal to the area enclosed by the curve. Work done is equal to area enclosed by the curve. That is something that enclosed by the curve. Work done is equal to area enclosed by the curve. That will be a closed curve, of course. So it will give you some more ideas, like, okay, so here in our case, in the example shown here, the work done has been represented something like the arrow is in the clockwise direction. So, you know, this area is negative and the other below area was positive. So, the net area will be equal to what? Negative here. So, what is shown here as the shaded area here, that is negative. So, the net work done is negative in the example shown here. Okay. And so, if you think of that, if the work is done in the opposite direction, what's the meaning? Like if I reverse the arrows, it means that below curve, the curve at the bottom will represent a sort of expansion, which will be negative, and the other one will be showing what? Compression, that will be positive. So the net work done will be positive in that case. Okay, so it depends on the direction which the work done also. So you can just clearly understand one thing, the work done in any thermodynamic process that is shown here, it is represented by the area under the PV diagram in general. And in the case of a cyclic process where we begin and end at the same macro state of the system, the work done during the entire process will be equal to the area enclosed by the curve there. So you can always think, hope you remember that we define what is known as a reversible process. And you know what is the difference between a reversible process and a cyclic process in general, where I stated without doubt that every reversible process will be a sort of cyclic process, but all cyclic process need not be reversible process. You can clearly understand why it is so. So you can think of what will be the area under the curve or area enclosed by the PV diagram of a reversible process, that you can always just think of. Okay, and you hope you remember that in the case of a reversible process, the initial and final points are actually the same, but the process will be passing through the same state, same set of equilibrium states as it was in the forward thing. So think over these concepts. So the take back of the session will be that work done in any thermodynamic process can be calculated directly from calculating the work done under the PV diagram. Okay, thank you.